Hi there.
So, we're trying something new today, this month. I am coming to you via webcam as opposed to my normal column. With the holidays fast approaching, I want to talk about family and what it means to me and maybe what it means to you as well as a person who comes to my column. Before I get started, I absolutely want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart. It means so much that you come back monthly and read my columns and stay in touch with my life. It means a lot, honestly. So thank you. So for me, family, my sister's always really been my mom. When I was very young, my mother was always busy. I think she absolutely did the best that she could, the best that she knew. With her limited education, but my sister absolutely became my mother when I was younger, and my mom now is slowly becoming a friend of mine, which feels good in a way, but she's still got her moments where she doesn't understand, and so I want to discuss what's right and what's wrong in my life when it comes to how people interact with me, most importantly, my family and friends. So for me, no matter how much plastic surgery someone has or hasn't had, I've never had plastic surgery, but I'm pretty sure that I look pretty different from what I did when I was younger. I'll always be my mother's little boy. There's nothing I can do to change that. And how dare I ever try to take that away from her? What if comes down to is learning how to live respectfully with each other and know that just because my mom says he by accident, she's not saying it to be mean. She's saying it because I was a certain person for 13 years to her, and I'll always be that person. My nieces are very young. I have two young nieces. One's 10 and one's 14 now, I believe. And they both know Zia. However, on my sister's wedding video, I'm dressed as a boy. And I gave my sister away. And so my nieces very much know that their Zia used to be a Zio. And I don't have an issue with that. I'm not that person who went around and told everyone to give me the pictures of me as a man and I want them because I have to burn them. Oh my God, I can't have them around. I had a life before I became me. I knew people before I became me. And I can't take those memories away from them. And every photograph is a memory. First time I hung out with my niece, there's a picture of that and I was dressed as a boy. Yeah, it can be sad sometimes because I look at those pictures and go, gosh, like, why couldn't I have been born a woman? Like, why do I have to explain this to people? But then, like I've said before, I said when I do my Trans 101 classes at Ryerson, I always say one very important thing. I used to think that God was punishing me for something maybe my mom did, or, you know, maybe humping in a book bag and being married, something like that. And then I used to think, oh my God, what did I do? And then I realized, wait a minute, God isn't trying to punish me. God's given me a gift. Me. This doesn't mean that you have to feel this way. This is how I feel. I feel like I've been strong enough to be able to receive this gift so that I can talk to people like you who watch me and who read my column. Because it gives me a voice. I have something to talk about. And people listen. So, yeah. I just want to say that, like, during the holiday season, I know it's hard when your mom calls you gay because she doesn't understand. And I know it's hard when your dad doesn't want to hang out with you because he just doesn't get it. You got to give them time to grieve that. People need time to grieve the person you were before. Allow them to do that. Don't take that away from them. Give them the space they need. You'll feel much better. And they'll come around. And if they don't, well, honey, you're better off without them. I know that's a really hard thing to say when it comes to family and when it comes to friends that you've maybe had your whole life. But if they can't respect the choices that you've made, and that big choice was to be happy, then you don't need them in your life. Because how many other things in your life aren't being respected? Food for thought. Anyhow, I am going to stop babbling. And again, thank you from my sincerest heart for tuning in. It really, really means a lot. Please comment. Please share. You can catch me on YouTube at www.youtube.com/... I don't know. Samantha Lozon. You can also find me on most social networking sites, be it Twitter, be it Facebook, MySpace, any other number of sites. You can find me there as well by using Samantha Lozon. Thanks for tuning in.